that melancholia means pain involving limb. It is first described by the Mitchell, so it is also known as the Mitchell's disease. On the base of causes, erythromelalgia is divided into two types, primary erythromelalgia and secondary erythromelalgia. Primary erythromelalgia, it is idiopathic, but the most probable cause are the gene mutation. When there is a genetic mutation occur in the CS951 gene, then there is hyperactivation of the sodium voltage gate channel. Sodium is the ion which play important role in the depolarization. And when the sodium influx will be occur, so the more sensation of the pain will be happen. The secondary cause of the erythromelalgia is the myeloproliferative disorder. In the myeloproliferative disorder, bone marrow produces abnormal amount of cells. So in this, we can see erythrocytosis, thrombocytosis, and also lymphocytes will be increased. Pathogenesis. There are different theories on the pathogenesis of the erythromelalgia, neuropathy, vasculopathy. In the vasculopathy, the narrowing of the blood vessels occur. For example, this one is the normal tumor of the blood vessel. And this is a narrowing. When there is a narrowing of the blood vessel, then the volume of the blood will be low. And due to the erythrocytosis, the red blood cells volume is a high, meaning that the hematocrit volume is a high. And it favors to viscosity. Due to viscosity, and then the platelet level aggregation. So in this state, volume and the time will take more to capture the tissue to get its nutrition. When there is a low level of the nutrition, then it causes the ischemia. And due to the ischemia, the tissue also will capture low oxygen. It's known as a hypoxia. And due to the hypoxia, oxidative phosphorylation process will be low. And ATP will not produce. In this way, mitochondria will be damaged. I had a case in Asian Medical Institute with a 42-year-old lady with a prickling, burning sensation. Severe pain on visual analytic scale was 9. Swelling, redness of feet, increased local temperature, the pulse of the peripheral arteries was symmetrical and palpable. You can see here the visual analog scale. First of all, how we do the visual analog scale? Visual analog scale for the sign, for the pain. Pain is a symptom. We can't observe the pain. If any patient comes to us, we can't observe. But for visual analog scale, we use to assess the pain. In the visual analog scale, for example, this one is a no pain. Here at the 10, there is a severe pain. And our patient had a 9, so she was suffered with the severe pain. Lab diagnostic, vascular Doppler investigation. In the vascular Doppler investigation, there was a platelet form. ECG, in the ECG, ECG was normal. In CBC report, we seen the increased level of the red blood cells, more amount of the red blood cells, white blood cells, and also platelets. Treatment. In the treatment, we gave amitriptyline 10 mg per dose at night, gabapentin 300 mg per dose 3 times a day, pentoxifilin 1 ml normal saline 250 ml intravenous, also ketoprofen and aspirin 1/4 per day. We gave the aspirin for the anticoagulant factors as anticoagulant. In the management, these management are used to treat all over the world to treat the erythromelalgia. Anticonvulsive drug, antidepressant drug, corticosteroid, anesthetic, and alternative PCEA. This means that patient control epidural analgesia. We inserted the catheter at the lumbar region at L3 and L4 with the lidocaine, also rivocaine, and dexamethasone for the anaphylactic shock reaction. And the patient will be relieved from the pain. Definitely. Conclusion. We know the treatment is the subject of the research, and we have been only succeeded to pain management, and these are treatment on the basis of experiment. At the end, I would like to thank Jalalabad State Medical University, organizers, audience, last but not least, my friends, my colleagues, for this encouragement and support.